Hello, Karina. Essa here from Social Media Worldwide, and in this video I want to share with you how to create attention-grabbing Pinterest pins. Pinterest is among the top 5 social networks, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and LinkedIn. And since the average Pinterest user spends around 1 hour and 17 minutes on the network a month, it's definitely a social network to consider for your online marketing efforts. Plus, what makes Pinterest even more powerful is that pins receive an average of 10 repins. Repins are the equivalent of Facebook shares. This makes Pinterest a very useful tool for traffic generation because you can benefit from people spreading the word about you and your content. So how do you create attention-grabbing Pinterest pins to leverage the power of this social network? First, you need to appeal to Pinterest users. 80% of Pinterest users are women, so ideally your pins should be targeted at women. Plus, most users access Pinterest at certain times in their lives, such as when they bought a new home and are looking for interior design ideas. They also access the network when they're about to get married for wedding-related ideas. They also access the network when they have small children and they're looking for ways to entertain them, such as arts and crafts ideas. Pinterest users also access the network with a shopping mindset. In other words, they usually intend to look for products to buy compared to other social networks such as Facebook, where people log in to mainly connect with other people. This is why it's not surprising that pins with prices receive 36% more engagement. Therefore, make sure you take into account all these facts when creating your pins. Secondly, to create attention-grabbing pins, your pictures have to be unique, original, and artistic. This is why it's best if you create your own pictures instead of just using already existing ones that might have been used already and that people might have seen already. On Pinterest, it's always the most beautiful and creative pins that get the most attention. For example, should you be publishing a pin about strawberries, you'll notice that some existing pins are very unique, such as the unicorn chocolate covered strawberry or rose shaped strawberries. What this means is that your pin would be competing with pins of that caliber. Take another example with Christmas related pins. You could display a standard picture of a Christmas tree, but you'd be competing with pins such as Christmas trees made only with pine cones, which is very original, or Christmas trees made of wood, sticks, or books. The third way to create attention-grabbing pins is by including keyword-rich pin descriptions and keyword-rich board descriptions. Every time you upload a pin, you need to also include a keyword-rich description. For example, if your pin title is 7-minute cardio workout for women, your description could be, "The 7-minute workout for women is perfect if you're busy and don't have time to go to the gym. Simply follow this daily 7-minute workout to get back into shape fast." If you can add the keyword or keyword phrase as many times as possible in the description, the better it is. But make sure your description sounds natural instead of sounding like you've desperately tried to include your keywords as many times as possible. The fourth way to create attention-grabbing pins is by publishing infographics and how-to tutorials. Infographics are pictures with information on them, like this one, for example, about smoothies, which displays 7 types of smoothies and their recipes for different times during the day. This other infographic, titled How to Become a Runner, displays a 7-week running routine to teach people how to run for longer and eventually become a good runner. To create infographics, you can use the tool pictochart.com, which makes it easier to create them faster by using their ready-made templates. Simply choose among their hundreds of templates and make the changes you need. The fifth way to create attention-grabbing pins is by making sure they are the right size. Pins that are narrow and long tend to perform much better than square pins. Ideally, your pins should be 735 times 1102 pixels. A great tool to create these images is canva.com. When you log into Canva, simply click on Pinterest graphic. When you do, any images you create on Canva will be the right size. You can then upload your own images by clicking on Upload, or you can choose from their thousands of images available by clicking on Search and typing in keywords for the type of image you're after. For example, if you type in computer, it will display hundreds, if not thousands, of images with computers you can use. The images will either be free to use or cost a dollar, or available only to pro accounts if you upgrade your free Canva account to a pro account. The sixth way to grab attention with your Pinterest pins is by publishing your pins at the right time, when your audience is most likely to see them. A great tool to find out the optimal times to publish your pins and schedule them in advance is tailwindapp.com. This tool will let you know when the best times to publish your pins are after you've linked your Pinterest account to your Tailwind account. Plus, when you install the Tailwind Google Chrome extension, you'll notice that on any picture on the web, the Tailwind image will appear, allowing you to schedule these images to be published on your Pinterest account at certain times. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, I've got an even better bonus for you. If you want to know how to leverage the power of Pinterest even further, I've got my Pinterest account optimization video tutorial. I'm going to play a preview in just a second. Click the tab on this video and it's going to take you to where you've got instant access to that full video. Plus, you're going to get another 3 videos from our best-selling Pinterest Pro home study course, and it's not going to cost you anything. In these additional 3 bonus videos, I'll reveal how to leverage the power of Pinterest group boards for more traffic, how to monetize your Pinterest account even if you're a complete beginner, and how to scale your Pinterest marketing efforts thanks to the power of Pinterest ads. If you've got any questions, put them in the comments below. Click on the thumbs up, it really helps us out. And also remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way you'll see our newest videos. See you soon. Hello and welcome to this video where I'll share with you how to create and optimize your Pinterest account. So to create a Pinterest business account, go to business.pinterest.com and click on join as business. But if you already have a Pinterest account that is not a business account, then still go to business.pinterest.com and it will ask you to convert your current account into a business account. Instead of join as a business, it will say convert. So click on convert and follow the prompts. So here, let's pretend we don't have an account. So let's get started. I'll click on join as a business and then it will ask you for your email address. So put an email address which you have the login details to, you have access to, because sometimes if you can't log into your Pinterest account, it's good to have access to the email account associated to the Pinterest account just in case something happens with the logins to your Pinterest account. It can be really tricky sometimes if you no longer have access to the email address associated to your Pinterest account. It can be really tricky to log in again. So I'm just going to put an email address I have created. Then choose a password. Make sure that you save your password somewhere that you remember. So I'll just create a password here. Now the business name. You have 2 choices. It can be your personal name if you are the face of your brand. So for example, Tony Robbins, he doesn't have a business name. His name and business name is the same, Tony Robbins. Or it can be your business name. So either way, either your personal name if you're building a personal brand or your business name. So here I'm going to pretend it's a personal name. And then choose the category. So you can put other if it doesn't fit any of these categories. So I'm going to put brand here. And then the website is optional. So always, of course, put a website link. So I'm just going to make one up and go to create account.